sneaky around.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah. very special event. We have worked very hard preparing for this occasion, and we hope you all enjoy. Please join me in prayer. Dear God, thank you for bringing our families and friends and family together for this very special event. Please watch over our graduates as they begin their bright futures and bring our undergraduates back for another successful year in the fall. In your holy name, amen.
When I first dropped out of high school, it was due to my laziness and not wanting to get up from bed in the morning. Well, then since I was really doing nothing with my life, my mom decided to put me to work. She got me a job at McDonald's as a cashier. It was okay, but standing at the cash register all day with just half hour break and eating junk food really got to me. I had to wake up at 6 in the morning in order to catch the bus, and only had 30 minutes to get ready. So that got me thinking, I'm already getting up early in the morning, so why not just go back to school? I went back to Foreman and talked to the Dean of Attendance. He said, sure, you can come back. It will take you a while to graduate, but you can make it. But after 2 weeks of trying to be a new person, my laziness got to me again, and I started staying in bed again. And keep in mind that I had quit my job at McDonald's during this time. So since I was already rubbing it again in my bed, my mom decided to put me to work again. This time, the job was construction. This was with my uncle. And believe me, after one day working there, he would want to be in school. I didn't want to return to Foreman because I didn't want to start the cycle all over again. So I Googled and started searching for other schools. One stood out to me, Lakeview Academy. I saw a picture of it and thought, this seemed like a nice small school, so I decided to call. The first person who picked up the phone was Bob. He said, come on by for a tour. I was excited. I thought since it was a private school, I would see fancy hallways and chairs, and who knows, and I was looking forward to meeting new students and many new friends, but I got lost. I kept looking and looking, trying to find this big private school. Finally, I asked a police officer for directions. He told me the school was right down the block. I was surprised. I didn't see any school. All there was a church. So I decided to go into a church for more directions. Going up the stairs, I saw a tiny sign that read, Lakeview Academy, upstairs. I went upstairs and rang the doorbell. Bob answered, and I thought he was a cheerful fellow. He gave me a tour, and I was surprised to see only one hallway and two classrooms. But I got the comfortable feeling of a cozy home. This made me decide to give it a chance. My first days in classes, there were only a few students. I kept thinking that more students must be hiding in another classroom that I didn't know about. I decided to keep quiet and not speak up so I would embarrass myself. The kids didn't look intimidating, but I didn't want to try to be the class clown. Well, at first. People said hi, they were nice and polite. I thought it was too good to be true. How could all these students be so polite and be in high school? And then I found out their ages. I was 17 at the time. There were some students who were 20 or even 21. I got confused. Was I in a high school or some college? Once I heard the student stories, it all started to make sense. They were here because they wanted somewhere so they could get the education they need and get a hope for what they want to do after high school. Getting jobs and going to college. Me personally, I didn't want to go to college or get a job. I just wanted my diploma. Well, at least at first. But when I started to get to know students, they all had goals in the future that looked brighter than mine. Some of them already had jobs, making money, being successful. But me, I couldn't even finish my work on time. So I decided to just be as successful as they were. I thought, I want to have a career. I want to go to college. So I buckled down and did my work, finished my reading and writing. And I'll admit, it was hard. I learned a lot, who to trust and who not to trust, and how to be smarter with my decisions. It is great to see everyone with their caps and gowns today. And I hope this is not the last time we see each other. And we are the last graduates of Lakeview Academy. How do I do this without being cheesy? Well, you see, this isn't the end. Sure, this is the end of our childhood, and we are adults now. We are finding our place in the world. So I tell you all, yes, we had our ups and downs here. And sure, the school could be a little odd, but I'm 100% sure that at some point in your future, at your job or at college, you will look back and remember something about this school, and it'll make you laugh or smile. Just know that I'm proud of us, of all that we have accomplished, and all that we will accomplish in the future. So I want to thank the LBA, the teachers, the students, the volunteers, my family, especially my mom and dad, and my brother and sister. And, well, we made it, guys. That's 2015.
When I was a student at Perspectives, I was the girl who had drama almost every day. I never had much luck in my old school. Most of the people there were violent and childish. There was no solution in sight. The staff let the students rule rather than the staff controlling the students. The staff were bystanders and didn't take charge. This wasn't the type of environment I needed. I needed to find a school where I would feel safe and wouldn't have to worry about dealing with chaos. After I was gifted with the most handsome baby boy ever, I knew I needed to make a change. I wanted to go to school where I would be able to focus and actually get work done. The Lakeview Academy is the school that most of my family members attended. They enjoyed being here. Aunts, uncles, and my mom graduated here. This school helped me to graduate 1 year early. I took the opportunity because I was motivated to make a change and challenge myself to do more. While here, I worked really hard on finishing all my assignments. I was able to get a job with the help of another student. I managed to use my time to study and be a caring mother. I was able to bond with my peers. Our first bonding moments were when we went sailing. Another bonding moment was when we were able to interact with each other during our Christmas play. Having fundraisers helped all of us communicate better. We were successful in raising enough money for our senior trip. In peer group, we helped each other get through our problems and learn to express how we felt. I enjoyed the support and motivation given by my family and friends. The bonding that happened here helped me to realize that others cared in a positive way. I feel like I can accomplish more if I put my mind into doing things for the right reasons. Thanks to the staff here, who pushed us to succeed and provided us a good education.
Honestly, never thought I would make it here, being on stage and getting ready to get my diploma. I'm thankful that I have an opportunity to further prosper in life. I want to say right off the bat that I'm thankful that I have a mother and a family who supported me through thick and thin. If she hadn't taught me the things that she has, I might still be at math, arguing with teachers and fighting other students. I might be a dropout, trying for a GED, maybe a full-time job. Acted out my years at Madden. I was out of hand most of the time, talking back to teachers and just being wild. I know I was hated by a lot of people because of the way I acted. Thinking back now, I regret it all. I let that whole social scene get to me, and under that pressure, I changed. I was failing most of my classes, and the classes I did pass, I passed with ease. I was a freshman in my sophomore year, and a sophomore in my junior year, but I didn't care. I disappointed my family a lot in those years, and to them, I apologize. I hope they forgive me now that I'm here. It has taken some time, but I'm finally going to graduate. The teachers and staff of LBA, they have been good to me. No matter the frustration or even the trouble I may have caused them. They have been there for me and have helped me as well. So thank you to June, Deborah, Bob, and Anita for our wonderful time at this wonderful school. The students here have helped me also enjoy my time here at LBA. I want to thank you all as well, even though we may or may not see each other again. I'm glad to have met you all. I hope you all become successful people in the years to come. You see, my education is important to me, and I plan on continuing on in college. So thanks again to all the people who have helped me in my time of need, and congratulations to the other students who are graduating.
volunteers were great, but they weren't enough to keep those unruly boys. line. So, that is to say that we have had all kinds of volunteers doing all kinds of wonderful things for the students of this school since the very beginning. And they have brought all kinds of wonderful opportunities to our students that they would not have had if they just had boring old us teachers. So we are very, very grateful. And I wish to thank them. And I'm going to read their names and ask them to come up while I'm reading their names and just stand across the way here. Heather Black started last year and came and ran a sewing group for us. Frank is wearing the tail coat, which he just finished yesterday with her help. Bob Friedlander has been coming twice a week as regular as a clock for more years than I can remember. Have you counted them? I think it might be more than 20, but anyway, almost 20, he says. Candace Harbaugh started coming and helping us out and turning our chorus into a choir a number of years ago. She is a professional singer and music teacher. Anna Herm, I'm sorry I left her name off the program, but if you saw the fantastic way that these students are giving their speeches tonight, a lot of that is due to her starting a once-a-week improv group. And their confidence and their speaking ability just blossomed. Yours. Sherry and Terry Kuberski have done a number of lovely things for us, and you saw them today in their roles as drummers. Kelly Martin has been here over 20 years. She comes first period, and sometimes there's only one student here because our students are not noted for their promptness, and she has never given up, and she never once walked out because there was only one student here. I probably would have done that. And finally, Paul Strom, who continues to baby our computers along. You're almost done with that, Paul. So, I want to thank them all. You can give them a round of applause now.
late April 2012 when I was sleeping at home and received a phone call from my mother. She woke me up to tell me I had been dropped from school. At that time, I said a few words and went back to sleep. I woke up on time for work and rode my bike to the local bike shop and just carried on with my week. I was excited about starting high school because of the sports, meeting new faces. I thought I would meet a lot of people with mutual interests, and I did. Freshman and sophomore year were great. I was the main defender for the varsity soccer team, the center for the varsity volleyball team, and part of the varsity bowling team. As a busy student with assignments, sports, and a full-time job, I maintained a 3.0 GPA. But early my junior year, my friends and teammates changed. They began to want me to do negative things with them. I decided to create my own path. I stopped playing sports and kept to myself. I did this to avoid all negatives. I didn't want to put any more effort into school. I was focused on my job. With 3 years of experience as a bicycle mechanic, I was promoted to lead mechanic in the shop. The pay was more than what any high school graduate could earn. Therefore, I wasn't particularly upset when I received that phone call from my mother that morning, telling me I had been kicked out of high school. Shortly after I was dropped from school and picked up a second job at another bike shop, I had two jobs working over 60 hours a week, and I was very happy. I thought I had life all figured out. That same year, I started my own business, Home Cycles. Almost 3 years later, I decided I should return to school, earn my diploma, and continue to college. I was doing well, but I reached a dead end. I wanted more. I browsed the internet looking for schools and found Lakeview Academy. I decided this time was for sure. It would be my last resort. When I called, the principal answered the phone. She told me the school was closing. Enrollment days were done for at Lakeview Academy. I mentioned to her I only needed 2.5 credits to graduate. She was also glad to hear I was holding a job, so she said perhaps they could accept me. I took my transcripts in that same hour, returned the next day for my interview with Anita. The following day, I started. My dad has always advised me to be different and to avoid all negatives. He once told me, someone else has done it, but create your own path. Some nights I would dream of not having to lie anymore. Nothing but a dream. For the last 3 years, I lived a successful life. Nothing to be proud of. The topic, high school graduate, was nothing but a forced lie in order to be a successful dropout. I managed to become a bicycle mechanic and an automobile technician without being a high school graduate. Today, it's no longer a lie, nor a dream. I'm truly proud to say I'm an Audi technician with 6 years of professional mechanical experience and a high school graduate, with the dream of becoming a mechanical engineer. Thank you all of Lakeview Academy.
At Lakeview Academy for helping me graduate. From the teachers to the volunteers, everyone helped me discover something special about myself. If it wasn't for Principal Deborah, I would have probably never picked up a novel in my life. If we had one chapter to read for homework, sometimes I would read three extra if the book was really interesting. My favorite book that we read was called Unbroken. The year after we read this book, the movie came out, and I was disgusted by how much detail was left out. So I want to thank her for helping me realize I actually like to read and prefer books to movies. Aside from helping me in math, Bob helped me gain the confidence while playing sports. Before, I used to try to avoid gym class as much as possible because I did not run fast enough. Even though I still don't run fast enough, Bob helped me gain the confidence that I didn't have before. I even requested to have gym every day, but he didn't go for it. Something June taught me was that I shouldn't be so gullible. She used science not to only show me, but the whole class, that people can make you believe anything by twisting words and making something sound either really great or really horrible. She did this by telling us about something called the hydrogen monoxide. I don't know if you can read, so I'll read it out for you. It says, is this eating fresh? Subway makes bread with an ingredient called hydrogen monoxide. HMO is an evil chemical used then as an industrial solvent in Poland. It is used in the production of yoga mats and as fire retardant. It's even a waste product of nuclear power reactors. It's definitely not fresh. Ask Subway to remove the hydrogen monoxide from their products. But in reality, what HMO is just water. If you see on the corner, you can even see that it says H2O pills. So once again, another life lesson learned at Lakeview Academy. Throughout high school, I made and lost a lot of friends. I came to realize that people come and go for a reason. Even though I didn't have many friends, or there was times I didn't have any besides the people here at school, I never felt lonely because I always found myself talking and laughing with someone. Or if it was personal, I always asked. Anita was always there for us. Since she was a counselor, she always gave us the best advice. I didn't always listen to her, but when I did, I didn't always listen, but then after I did what I wanted, I realized that I should have. And I'm really thankful for her. Apart from our teachers, the volunteers are also really great people. Thank you all for taking time out of your daily routine to come teach us something. Kelly using history to teach us how to come down to a conclusion. Anna using art and improv to help me talk and act in front of a group. If it weren't for her, I would not be able to stand up here and read my speech. Heather for showing me how to use a sewing machine. Something most people my age might not know. Robert on Russian literature and for helping us perform. Robert on Russian literature and teaching me proverbs that I might need to use if I ever find myself at a fancy party. And Candace for helping us with songs that we have been performing. Each and every one of you are fantastic. In a way, I'm happy that I am part of the last class of Lakeview Academy, but I am also sad because the school has been here for 42 years, and it's something I thought we would never see coming to an end. It is a shame other people would not get to experience all the great stuff the school had to offer, but hopefully this generation can pass it down. I would definitely miss all the family moments we had with each other, the meals we had together, when we all sat down to talk about how we felt, and all the other fun stuff we did, which is a lot to me. I hope that we can all keep in contact somehow, but all I know is that Lakeview Academy, the memories I made here, the teachers, volunteers, students, and even the seniors will always have a special place in my heart.
Thank you. also likes. He has a business fixing bites. More school awaits you, so we hear. Just get it done within a year. Credentials earned in auto-tech, and then collect a bigger check. His friends like cars and bikes as well. How far he'll go, we cannot tell. Hard work.
wanted to be average, to be normal. As a child, I held myself back in school. As a child, I held myself back in school because I didn't want to be like everyone else. I didn't want to stand out because of my good grades. In high school, I wanted the typical high school experience. I wanted a balance of fun and stress and a broad circle of close friends. I had a chance to have that experience too, but I blew it. After that, for a long time, I believed that I had failed for doing so badly at regular school. I thought that going to an alternative school meant that I was incompetent, lazy, unintelligent. In fact, when people would ask me what school I went to, I would be too embarrassed to tell them I went to an alternative school. So I just say I went to my old high school. But as I stand here today, I know that I was not meant to have a typical life. None of us is. Sorry, I am not average. No one is. Everyone here dressed in caps and gowns has had a different high school experience than most. However, it has taken me until now to realize that that is not a bad thing. I realize now that you cannot improve if you don't make mistakes. And it's not the weaker you are, the more you will fall. It is the harder you fall, the stronger you will be when you get up. Our mistakes are not testaments of who we are, or rather, what we can be. We can be more than our mistakes. We can persevere and succeed, and we can always grow and improve. And we must keep growing. We must continue. Improvement is a never-ending process that we cannot delay because we feel so comfortable or we feel so miserable in our current point in time. To grow, we must suffer. We must feel pain. We must make mistakes. But we must also laugh and experience joy and relief and bliss and peace. And most importantly, we must learn. You should never feel pressured by your peers or your family or society to become someone that you know you are not. That is not growing. If you live your entire life letting everyone's perception of you dictate your behavior, you will not grow as a person. You know what you need, you know what you can improve on, and you must improve for yourself because you know you can do better. And you must also appreciate yourself and learn how to love yourself because you are the only you in this entire world, and the world cannot afford to lose you or have you not lived to your full potential. And as I close this chapter of my life, I know that I have not failed. I know that I am stronger and somewhat wiser than I was 4 years ago. I am equipped to take on anything that presents itself down the road. And as I go into college, I know that although I'll be one in some 30,000 students, I will be different. We will all be different. And that is good. I wish I could go back in time to visit myself in those days when I was completely lost and convinced I had no future. I would tell myself, do not worry, everything will be okay.
Despite always being busy, always working, numb, a always slaving, day after day. She still always found reasons to be grateful. Like her brother before her, she demanded a better life than what she had in her homeland. Not just for her, but for her future children. By 1994, my mother had gathered just enough money and courage to do what everyone's ancestors at some point had to do. She risked everything to come to America, Dallas, Texas, to be precise.
Hey.
Dallas, Texas, to be precise. And a month later, I was born. My father, Abraham, was only in my life my first 2 years. All I know, or have been allowed to know about him, is he was a heavy drinker and attempted to drown me at the age of two. After this, he was banned by the courts from seeing me again. His whereabouts are still unknown to us. My mother, though, named me after the biblical icon, Abraham, the father who had as many descendants as the stars in the sky. You know, I've always admired my mother's loyalty to religion. Yet, despite this, I don't like being called Abraham. I wish to be Abe, or preferably AB. Through the years, my mother and I have moved from Dallas to Aurora, to Chicago to Dallas, to Chicago, back and forth and back and forth. About 3 years ago, we settled in the areas between Humboldt Park and Wicker Park. Yeah, we moved a lot. The reasons varied, from including money owed to a landlord, abuse from my mother's then husband, bad neighborhoods, and simply just missing our family in Dallas. I'm the oldest. I have one brother and paternal twin sisters. And I remember so much from my childhood. My typical day as a first grader was this. Wake up on time, proudly make myself some cereal, tie my shoes, grab my book bag, and sit in a very prideful way that demonstrated I was ready for the day. I'd go to school, try to make friends, was excited when I did, and, you know, was a huge teacher's pet. And when the day was done, I'd wait in the office, because I'd always be the last student to be picked up. See, my mother never had a car. This was true for 18 years. Eventually, I'd get home to my mom and my baby brother Ezekiel. Once home, I'd get started on homework. I had so much trouble understanding the material. My mother, being only Spanish speaking, would only further confuse me. Being the family translator, a teacher, kid with no friends, no computer, no cable, and, you know, always a father to me, a younger brother, and in essence, a loser. It all got to me. See, I was never allowed to play with non-Christian kids. My mother never appreciated normal American things such as comics, worldly music, you know, Pokemon, football, skateboarding, you know, crude jokes, and wrestling. Man, my mother never hated wrestling. But I did all those things anyways. If I was ever caught going against the word, I'd receive aggression. And I'll soon none of that mattered though. Simply because I had no time for it. Why? Well, because my sisters were born. At the time, Ezekiel was 3, Jennifer and Natasha were brand new, and I was 10. I never saw raising them as a burden. I saw it as my number one priority. Yet, for some reason, people seem to think that I didn't love them. I love them more than anything in the world. Their dad would make their birthday celebration better than anything my mother could have ever done for me. He thought I resented that. No, I love them. they're like my children. And I have to apologize for saying these words because I hate saying these words, but I hate him. You know, for a time, I also hated my mother. Yeah, I said that. But I was naive. I hated how quickly she would blow a situation out of proportion because of her overprotectiveness. For instance, when I was a kindergartner, a friend accidentally poked my eye. Something that made me twitch for a few hours. Oh, baby, right? Not exactly, see. The same day, my mother went into the school, yelled very angrily at the principal, demanding he be suspended. And, well, when they refused, she demanded my transfer to another school. I never saw Marshawn again. Things like this happen constantly. And when I was little, I loved acting. Always got the lead roles. My mother never made it to one of my performances in school, so she never saw me use what I thought was my greatest gift. As a result, I ended up dropping acting as my passion. You know, in the heat of arguments, I've often called her out on many things. I realize now that I should have been more grateful rather than adding to her pain. Eventually, my mother left my brother and sister's dad when he crossed the line and swung at her. Yes, she was a victim of domestic violence. You know, ever since then, she's never been the same. Always paranoid. I mean, you can still see it in her eyes today. This drove her to her worst, depressing stage. She became an alcoholic. Coming home drunk, waking us up, and leaving us trying to figure out what was going on and why she acted this way every single night. Yet, even so, things seemed all right when I entered high school. You know, until sixth grade, I loved school, enjoying doing whatever my teacher asked. But then it all just seemed to hit me. I felt that in the eyes of the other students, I was a total loser. I made myself do crazy things just to win popularity. I did what I wanted, when I wanted, and turned sixth through eighth grade into my personal playground. I then entered Alcott High School and continued to play, oh, so cool. Then I met this girl. She was sweet and kind. It was also the slowest relationship of my life. I waited 4 whole months for our first official kiss. Then after that, things escalated. We did what many teenagers do when alone. This, of course, led to us becoming pregnant. I was so happy. I mean, stupid, but happy. I started to search for a job and went secretly to daddy classes. Summer came and went, as it usually does. Then in August, it all came crashing down. She dumped me. 5 months pregnant. If that wasn't enough to send me into a downward spiral, finding out she was dating another guy 2 weeks later definitely did it. Regardless, though, I went to school. Depressed, but present. Then came the day I saw her. She had the moxie to invite him to come walk her home. Rumor was that they were making out in front of the park for everyone to see. Fortunately, I found out about it through my friends. You know, everyone was talking about how I was going to destroy the guy. Actually, I was planning to be very violent. Until a girl pulled me aside and told me to please ignore it and go home. You know, to this day, I don't know why I listened, but I did. I said nothing and left. It was at that point that I decided I didn't need school. When my son Christian was born in December, I wasn't allowed to see him. I didn't even know he had been born until 2 weeks after the fact. The one time I was allowed to see him, I wasn't allowed to hold him. I had to watch another man hold my child. So unofficially, I dropped out of school. I just stopped going. What I did with my time was simple. I worked, I laid in bed, and I did all things related to basketball. You know, there were always constant talks in my ear about me returning to school or at least getting my GED. My mother, co-workers, and practically everybody talked to me. I never listened. until I had a one-on-one talk with each one of my uncles. You know, they told me some things I never knew. In essence, they got to me. So I said to myself, let it all rest. I'll go back to school. Alcott, of course, wouldn't take me back. Neither would my neighborhood high school, Clemente. I was scared until Clemente told me about alternative high schools and handed me a list. The first name on that list was Lakeview Academy. So I came in. I was surprised at the size of it, but enthralled with the closeness that is Lakeview Academy. I was accepted. I got my act together and was living good. Word got through to my former classmates that I was no longer depressed and was actually doing better than before. Soon, I received a message from my son's mother. She was sorry, and more importantly, I could see my son. Now, I know most of you would never get up here on stage and reveal so much. See, I haven't told you everything, and most likely, I never will. You probably wonder why I'm publicly shaming my mother and family. See, I don't see it that way. Instead, I want to show each of you how far my mother and my family have come. My mother, through the grace of God, has been sober for years now. She now owns a 2015 Honda. And finally, she has a son who has graduated high school, the first in our family. My son's mother is now my fiance. And Chris is 4 years old and in preschool. My brother will be going to Presbyterian High School, the school he wants to attend. And my sisters are now in sixth grade, soon on their own paths. And myself, I'm excited to start college this fall and begin studying phlebotomy, renal dialysis, and respiratory therapy. Yet, none of this would have ever been possible were it not for this school. Lakeview gave me what no public school did. They gave me a chance. They didn't tell me I was too old at 16, that I'd make their school look bad, that they didn't want to take a chance on me. No. Instead, they accepted me. Bob, June, Anita, Laura, Deborah. Thank you. No, seriously. Thank you so much. At first glance, a majority of people are quickly to judge you, mostly because each one of you has a quality that isn't usually seen in public. But I could never allow myself to judge you for these things that make each one of you, you. You've not only never judged me, you've embraced me as your own. You know, it's things like this that really get to me. Especially when I think about how, after 43 years, three of which I've had the privilege to be a part of, this school will no longer be here. All I can say is thank you to the church for helping keep all this running for so long. Thank you to the community for your spiritual and financial support. And of course, thank you to each and every one of the volunteers and donors who took time out of their lives just to help us. Thank you for giving us a chance.
Principal's Award has been given for quite a few years to a student whose staff feels has made unusual significant improvement in one or more areas. No, thank you, Ron. Here. By God's grace. Here it is, the new one. We ran out of spots on the old one last year and had to have a new one made, and unfortunately the school's closing, so there are going to be a number of blank things until somebody finds another use for it. In any case, it says all things are possible with God. And we have added some names. There have been a couple years when we've given two, and there have been some years when we have not given it at all. We sat and talked about the students who had made significant, unusual improvement while here, by God's grace. And it will not surprise you, I think, when we give our award. But the first person we are giving this award to is someone who was only here for a year. And after we all shared our thoughts about the students, we decided that we're not saying this student is perfect, but we're saying that this student really came to us and was nothing but a hard-working, on-time, here every day delight. And so we are giving one of the principal's awards to Lola Gonzalez.
Jeremiah chapter 29, verses 11 through 14. The Lord says, "Surely I know the plans I have for you, plans for your welfare and not for harm, to give you a future with hope. Then when you call upon me and come and pray to me, I will hear you. When you search for me, you will find me. If you seek me with all your heart, I will let you find me, says the Lord."
Pray to me. When you search for me, you will find me. if you seek me with all your heart, you will. I will let you find me. Are you anxious about next year? Of course. I'm sure your parents are anxious too about what's going to happen next to your lovely child. Am I telling it? Excuse me. Anyone, life will be easier now that you're out of high school? Oh no, I'm not telling you that. I think if you stay on the right path, it'll be more fun than high school was. A whole lot more fun. But we teachers believe that you have more endurance and more inner strength, more hope than you had when you entered LBA, and we believe that God has wonderful plans for your future. The 2014-15 school year is over, and it's time to move on. I printed one other short passage in the program, just so you would have it. It's from Psalm 37. Trust in the Lord and do good, so that you will live in the land and endure security, or you can say safe. Take delight in the Lord, and the Lord will give you the desires of your heart. Commit your way to the Lord, trust in him and her, and he and she, our Creator, will act.
Likes to be called Amy. O God eternal, you have called this class of 2015 at this special moment in time to be the final graduating class of Lakeview Academy. You have led them through this time and supported their journey. You've been by their side when the road seemed long. You've laughed and cried with them. You've seen them through struggles too hard to bear and too difficult to name. You've been nearby urging them on, calling them to excel, coaxing them to finish this task of high school graduation. Because you, O God, have been steadfast, we give you thanks. We also give you thanks for the fortitude of each one of these students. We give thanks that they've heard your call and had the gumption and the courage to answer. We give thanks that even within adversity, they've persevered and made it to this day, ready for the next step in their lives. Because they have been steadfast, we give you thanks. We remember this night the teachers of our school and the volunteers who tirelessly worked to bring about this day. We give thanks for their gifts, their patience, their skill in teaching. And we give you thanks, O God, for their steadfastness. O God, you called this faith community 43 years ago to open their doors to students for learning. We pray that as this academy comes to a close, that our doors might stay open for some new form of learning, that our quest to serve those in our neighborhood might be emboldened by the witness of these students and all who came before them. For lives transformed through education and through the solid, generous provision for it, we feel so blessed this night. So God, we ask you to bless these graduates. Send them, each one, on their way safely, ready to make a difference in the world, ready to remain steadfast in their thirst for knowledge and their pursuit of excellence. Protect and guide them, we pray, this night and forevermore. Amen.
Oh, God. Daddy, is this your son?
Yes, it is.
I've heard. Okay.
Josiah. Hiya.
Thank you. Thank you so much. What do you want me to do?
Just I guess you just one question.
Okay.
How do you feel?
I'm sweating a lot, so but I'm very happy. I'm relieved. I'm relieved and I'm kind of dumbfounded right now. I don't know much else to say. College and try not to mess this up.
Question?
Oh, yeah.
How are you feeling right now?
I don't know, man. I feel pretty good. You know, I'm glad to have it, you know, all done and over with. I wish it wasn't over, but I really do appreciate the time I have here.
Come on, puppy.
I'm sorry, what?
What's the future for you?
Well, I'm trying to go to college for animation and photography.
Thank you.
Daddy, what's your
thing?
Daddy,
can I ask you a question?
Yeah,
sure,
no problem.
Daddy, how are you feeling right now?
Oh, you gotta warn me about that. Well, I feel amazing, man. There's no words to describe it. It's electrifying. I feel it all going through me right now. You know, I'm sad but happy at the same time.
Daddy,
so,
Daddy,
you know, I feel great.
Daddy,
so, you wanna say hi?
Hi. What's your name?
What's the future for you?
Future for me? Whatever I put in it. Anything. I want to go into a medical field. I'm going to go to Malcolm X College. I'm going to study renal dialysis, physical therapy, as well as... Yes, baby? And as well as... Yes? Phlebotomy. So, anything I wanted to hold. So, yes. Thank you.
Question?
Sure. Good. Pretty good. Yeah, that's all. Well, I'm happy that I finally graduated. I would say a big future. We'll find out. I can't tell the future. Well, just go to college. Right now, planning an associate's degree in automobile technology. After that, we'll see how things play out in life. Thank you.
Sure.
How are you feeling right now?
Really happy. And thankful for the teachers here. Well, I'm really applying for colleges, so I'll just see for the fall what happens next.
Thank you.
No problem.
You're welcome. Can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
How are you feeling?
Good. Very good. Graduated. Excited for what comes next, so.
Huh?
Yep.
What's the future for you?
College. Working. Police officer, and you know, just a bright future. I got everything set up, so yeah, great. All right, thank you.
and what I'm feeling right now. Well, I'm Joy Douglas-Strom. I'm the pastor of Lakeview Presbyterian Church, which has run this program for the last 43 years, and I'm feeling a real sense of bittersweet. I'm happy for the last graduating class, but feeling sad that we had to close. So, glad for all of the lives touched by this school and our great staff and over 200 graduates and 50 others who went on to finish their school in another area. So we had quite a run, and I'm excited and glad to have been a part of that. So that's all I have to say. What? Oh, good.
Where are you and what are you feeling right now?
What am I feeling right now?
Who are you?
I'm Anita Smith. I helped to start the school. I was the first teacher in 1972. I've been here ever since. The school is my life work and my love, really. I love working here. I love getting up every day, come to this place. So. Well,
yes, you just changed clothes.
Yes, you guys.
I'm feeling
really excited, shocked that I made the Principal Awards. future, hopefully I get into Palm Mitchell Beauty School, becoming a cosmetologist. You're welcome.
Sure.
I'm Deborah Bailey, and I'm feeling very, very grateful that we had such a wonderful last group of students in this school.
What's your role here?
I'm the principal. I also teach English and a few other things.
Any other thoughts on this whole thing?
Everyone says they've never heard such a great group of speeches, and also they were well enough presented that I think people understood almost every word, which is remarkable. Thank you.